And new at 5, as Danny just told you about those freezing temperatures coming to the valley, that also adds some risk to your outdoor workout.
13 Action News anchor Nina Porciuncula spoke with the doctor on how to stay safe outdoors.
It is safe for almost everyone to exercise, even though it is cold outside. But for some people, they need to check with their doctors first before putting on those workout sneakers, because conditions can be dangerous.
If you're trying to get a workout in as the temperatures drop, there could be a physical cost.
If you have underlying heart disease, especially coronary artery disease, or other vascular disease, you're at increased risk because your blood vessels are already constricted from the disease. And getting into a severe cold can actually constrict it more.
Dr. Jonathan Bakhtari of E7 Health compares what happens to your blood vessels when it's cold to stepping on a garden hose while watering plants.
You actually then go in the cold and it constricts it even more. Essentially, you're putting your foot even further down, and then at that point, it's not enough water to feed the plant, or not enough blood flow from the coronary arteries to the heart.
If you also have a history of asthma, you're putting yourself at risk for increased discomfort or injury.
A lot of people have triggers for what causes an asthma attack. So they have underlying asthma, but you know, certain things can trigger an attack. For a lot of people, cold weather and exercise can be a trigger for their asthma.
So before hitting the pavement,
if you're at all concerned, get a real workup, a detailed workup, and know your risks.
But even if you're healthy, when it gets really cold, our bodies overcompensate to perform tasks. That means our muscles and tendons tighten up and become less flexible, which can lead to muscle soreness or strains. So take that extra time to warm up before exercising. Nina Porciuncula, 13 Action News.